Welcome here to another new edition of AD and DT with Athletics Director of LeMoyne College here, Bob Beretta, and myself, Dan Tortora, a.k.a. DT. Bob, as always, it's great to see you and great to sit down and have another conversation.
Pleasure to be with you, Dan.
And today, a very, very special opportunity coming on the heels of the fact that there is now a lot of marketing around men's and women's basketball. I know that was very important to you to jump right into as we head into the winter to have a very special focus, a spotlight on LeMoyne, and I'd love to start there.
Yeah, great, Dan. Yeah, thanks for bringing that up, and it's a pleasure to be with you again. Yeah. Really has been a focus for us to try to elevate all aspects of our operation, and I really felt like we could utilize basketball as this wonderful platform to raise the profile of the campus in our athletic department. And I felt it was really important to find a way to try to identify a partner that we could lock arms with from a commercial radio standpoint and put our games back on commercial radio. Men's basketball at LeMoyne hasn't been on commercial radio in I think over a decade, and the women have only been sparingly a few games a season and not for over a decade. So we committed to a full schedule of regular season games and postseason, and we found a partner in Fox Sports Radio and Sam Furco, and so appreciative of that relationship. And they're going to be the home of LeMoyne basketball this winter, all 49 regular season games and hopefully many postseason games after that. And for us, we look at it as an opportunity again to tell this wonderful story of our student athletes, but also of the campus, of the college. We kind of look at it as an infomercial for 4 hours. If we have a doubleheader and we're on the air for 4 hours, we're going to be able to put our president on at halftime. We'll be able to put other key constituents and stakeholders and tell the story of LeMoyne College. And it's all about trying to elevate, right? Trying to raise the profile of this institution.
You know, and to have, like you said, more than a decade since the men's basketball side has been on commercial radio, and for the women over a decade as well, but even more sparingly, as you had mentioned, just, you know, the importance for you to make that return, that somebody could get in their car, turn on the dial, and hear LeMoyne for the first time in over 10 years.
Yeah, I think it's really important, and I'm not naive about online broadcast. There's great value to online broadcast, and we'll stay online. Our games will stay, remain available online, and the video stream will, I think that's so important worldwide to be able to reach that worldwide audience. But I also am a firm believer that to have that space in your local area on a commercial on the commercial dial, it is important for the fan that's going to hop in their car and put on the radio and hear 10 minutes of a LeMoyne game, or maybe they'll catch the interview at halftime with President Lemura, or they'll just get engaged in a way that they feel like they want to be part of what we're doing here at LeMoyne, whether that's coming to a basketball game, or whether that's becoming a friend of the department or the school through philanthropy, or if it's just being a partner and coming and supporting our teams at our events. All of that is very important to the leadership here and myself. And I thought that using the avenue of basketball and commercial radio and being able to reach AM, FM dial positions and then additional spots beyond Central New York with our relationship, it's really important to me.
You know, to have this opportunity for Nate Champion and Mary Grimes, what the conversation was like with them to tell Nate, hey, you know, we're going to have these games broadcasted live, and upon Mary's return, that she, the only experience she'll have as a head coach is to have her games broadcast.
They're very excited. I think we may be the only NE10 school. If not the only, there's only one or two others, but I think we're the only one that will have a commercial radio position this year where our games will be on commercial radio. So it's a differentiator for us as well. Yeah. It allows us to separate it. It helps both Mary and Nate in the recruiting aspect to be able to sell that to their families. It gives that perception of a bigger program, and I've talked about that since the day that I arrived at LeMoyne, is that I feel like we can carve our own niche in this market, and we can coexist with Syracuse very nicely. We can be great partners. We can have a symbiotic relationship, but there's a place for both of us in this community, and I feel like LeMoyne basketball is going to be a big part of that.
Looking at the upcoming season and knowing what was taken away from all different sports, you know, and basketball being a part of that as well, you know, they're the one thing that we've learned in this pandemic of over a year and a half is that it doesn't pick and choose, you know, and And in that case, with basketball on the men's and women's side, having to navigate high waters and break through it, to know that the return of basketball is going to create such a new spotlight. It seems perfect that you took a glass half empty and turned it into a glass half full to say basketball, like everything else, was affected, and now upon its return to a regular schedule, a regular postseason, that there is going to be a regular turn on the dial, and there it is. I mean, it seems like a beautiful way to navigate through something that wasn't that pretty at its onset.
Well, that's a great point, Dan, and I think we look at everything as an opportunity, right? Not obstacles or challenges. I'd rather view them as opportunities, and this is an opportunity to reengage as to our pre-pandemic form, but even beyond that, to elevate our offerings, our services to our student athletes, our product to the community. This is a great opportunity to reset in a way that's very strategic, and reset as a new and maybe better product than we were. And I feel like this is a wonderful opportunity to do that. And again, finding the right partner was key and critical to do that. Thanking you for your support is crucial to amplify our message, right? It's all part of the larger message, the larger strategy of raising the profile of this institution and of this athletic department. And I think people will see some billboards popping up potentially here in the community touting our basketball schedule. And again, we just want to be at the forefront of people's mindset that there's this wonderful alternative in the community, and it's LeMoyne. Let's go experience that. And I feel like once we get people on campus and interacting with our student athletes, they'll want to come back and they'll want to be part of a meaningful relationship with our college.
And I do want to give credit too, as we are inside of this AD and DT episode, and to the voices we're going to hear on these broadcasts, I think is very important, because they are a staple and they are returning to the airwaves again. So I think it's a beautiful thing that not only are you going to be on commercial radio, but that you have decided to keep along the voices that we've come to know.
Yeah, absolutely, Dan. I think when people talk about LeMoyne basketball, you think of Chris Granazio and Don Famillo, and two graduates and passionate broadcasters for LeMoyne basketball. In fact, I think either Chris or Don, they've broadcasted 800 consecutive LeMoyne basketball men's games, dating back for many decades, right? I think back into the 90s now. So it was important to reinsert their voices back into the broadcast. They've been right on through during the online period, and now to reintroduce their voices and their passion to the commercial airwaves, I think it's really important. They're excited about it. I think their loyal fan base and followers will be excited to hear them back on commercial radio, and we're putting together a network right now that we're going to be really excited about. And when we look back on accomplishments in April and May from the previous year, I feel like this basketball network is going to be something that we're going to be very proud of.
And the importance, too, of making sure on LeMoyne's side that you're built for this. Just what you can say to that effort in the technological world, that you're going to try and have a very seamless move into what you need. And obviously, you get the help that you need to get from commercial radio, but just what you've done to make sure that technologically you've advanced with the times at LeMoyne to be ready for this.
Yeah, no question. And sustainability, right? We're talking about sustainability, so that we look at introducing a program that can last over time. So we're looking at that right now. Infrastructurally, we're looking at that from our building standpoint, how we transmit our signals, all the mechanics. And then we put a corporate partner package in place, one that has not been experienced here at LeMoyne to this degree, that it's going to include many different fulfillment aspects, and one that fans will see immediately are courtside seats, and that'll include food and beverage. So if people want to be part that have ties to businesses, to our corporate program, and have access to those seats, they'd be able to contact me and they can do that. We have several folks and partners already on board, and there's also a donation aspect. So if people donate at a certain level to the athletic department, they'll also be entitled to two of those seats per game and have access to food and beverage. It's all fully loaded tickets, if you will. So it's all kind of part of that scheme, that master plan. I don't want to call it a scheme. It's a strategy to elevate. But many of the tentacles were connected. And again, I go back to our partnership and our relationship. It's critical to me that we had a partner that could help tell our story and amplify our message, and we found the perfect partner in Dan Tortora Broadcasting and yourself. So there are many layers to this plan. It wasn't just courtside seats, and it wasn't just corporate sponsorship, and it wasn't just broadcast on commercial radio. It was a deeply synergized plan with many different tentacles that are connected, and hopefully it'll all lead to elevating the profile of our school and enhancing the overall experience for our student-athletes. We want to deliver an extraordinary student-athlete experience, and again, we want them to feel like they deserve, that feel like they're in a world-class environment, and I feel like being on commercial radio just kind of adds a little bit of swagger to their step on the court.
And it is a beautiful thing that as these changes are being made, like you said, it's not just this, it's not just that, it's not just the other thing, but bringing them all together and being able to tell that story about the return of commercial radio, about courtside seats, about what VIP is going to feel like at LeMoyne. You know, I think that that is such a beautiful approach, and it really shows that you're spending no time to put your stamp on. And you know what you had at Army West Point for over 30 years, and what you expect out of yourself, and what you expect out of the people around you. I think that improving the profile of LeMoyne College, which is already a great thing, to put an improvement on that, to elevate that, you know, that they found the perfect person to do that, because the way that you've carried yourself with, I mean, when we first sat down and when we first met each other, when Mary was getting introduced as the new coach for women's basketball. To just get that initial feeling and that initial sit down, I knew who I was working with, I knew who I was dealing with, and I think LeMoyne has to understand that, you know, these moves that are being made, they all are working together toward a common goal, and you have definitely hit the ground running, and what you expect is something that I'm very excited to be a part of, because as a multimedia marketing partner, I get to watch behind the scenes and in front of the scenes what the Bob Beretta approach is going to be, and working with Linda Lemura, the president, and really this entire college, just what the expectations are. I'm excited to be a part of the inner workings of everything, because I get to see it firsthand, and I think that we're barely getting started, and there's already so much to be happy about. So, I mean, I know how you and I work. We can do 800 things, and we're at to 801, but you know, I think it's important to take the time to say thank you, that in less than half a year, you've already put LeMoyne in a spotlight and said, we're not going to wait for it, we're just going to turn the light on ourselves and shoot it directly at us, which I think is great.
Well, thank you. It's not about me, you know, it really isn't. It's about these wonderful 400 student-athletes that we have and trying to amplify their stories. And we're in full alignment with the educational mission of this institution. I've made no bones about that. That's our number one priority, and we feel like, as a good partner, athletics, I say this all the time, athletics is never going to be the most important element of any institution. If it is, then there's a misalignment somewhere. But we might be the most visible piece of an institution of higher education, and with that visibility comes great opportunity, and with that great opportunity comes tremendous responsibility, and we're taking it all very seriously. And again, it's just a chance. It's a way we can help advance our program a little bit at a time every day. And I think if we go back and look in 6 months, if we continue to make a little bit of progress every day, we'll be really pleased with the overall picture and how far we've advanced and the product that we've been able to deliver our student athletes and to make sure that they have this world-class, extraordinary experience, right? We talk about comprehensive excellence. I hold myself to that standard. I'm not saying that I reach that standard on a daily basis, but I aspire to and hold our staff to that. And I feel like we owe our best effort every day to our student athletes.
Yeah, and I think that that's incredible. And we'll get to see that firsthand with men's and women's basketball. And obviously, as things progress, get to see it in different ways with all of the programs and the great importance of each of these programs and what they've done. And we've gotten to tell so many stories in Dolphin Dive and, you know, from volleyball to the soccer fields and so on and so forth. I've had the absolute pleasure to speak with student, athlete, registered nurse, you know, people that have come from the community like Brian Pernomo and all of that. And so to tell these stories and to get to know the personalities and the makeup and the leaders that you're building here, I think that there's so much to gain from putting the spotlight on the athletic department at LeMoyne and on the college overall. And that's what I'm here for. And I know that the advancement to commercial radio and the advancement to VIP seating and doing different things and having a, you know, the the elevation factor of this is what you expect, this is what we're going to bring you. Under promise, over deliver. And I think that that's great. So I'm excited, just as anybody else, to turn on a dial or to walk in there and to see it and to know exactly what it looks like. And all I can say is save some food for me.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, and the one thing we didn't talk about is the product. We feel like we're going to put together a world-class product with Nate Champion and Mary Grimes. And we feel really good about the talent level in the program. And we feel like we have two fantastic young coaches to lead our young people. And I feel like the product is going to be something that people will experience high entertainment to come and watch our basketball teams play this winter.
And a bunch of assistant coaches that are coming onto the scene for the first time, which I'm very, very excited to see all of that. You know, Joanna Dabrowski is coming back here, who was recruited by Mary and now re-recruited by Mary to be an assistant coach. And then we have the likes of Ben Swank coming in for the first time on the men's side of things. And we have Speedy Fraser coming on as well. So there's a lot of good that is already happening before we even look at wins and losses, that Nate Champion and Mary Grimes are putting together staffs that are really going to get out there and hit the ground running, which I'm excited about.
Yeah, no question. And we're excited. We're excited about where we stand. We're excited right now with the leadership in those programs. We feel like there's a very high ceiling for both. We're a little interested to see what the teams look like on the court. I've been able to watch them at practice from time to time the past several weeks. But until you get into that competitive environment with so many new faces and having not played for 2 years, you know, at West Point we played last year in the winter, so we didn't have that year off. So I think right now it's very interesting to see how we respond, but I feel very confident in the leadership that we have in both programs that we're going to respond in a very compelling way.
That coming from AD Bob Beretta here at LeMoyne College, myself, DT Dan Tortora. AD and DT airs every first and third Wednesday during Dolphin time, exclusively on Wake Up Call with Dan Tortora at 9 a.m. Eastern time. You're watching and listening on youtube.com/wakeupcalldt, facebook.com/wakeupcalldt. And of course, you can find this and so much more on the LeMoyne tab on wakeupcalldt.com. Bob, as always, fins up.
Fins up, Dan. Thanks for being here today.
Appreciate it.